And at that moment, I got what pleasure I could out of the stolid indifference of the cart driver, who never looked about him at the scene which interested me, but jolted onward, leaving a trail of pungent odors from his pipe in the freezing eddies of the air behind him. It is still not at all, or not so much, the fact that troubles me. It is what to do with the fact. The question began with me almost at once, or at least as soon as I faced about and began to walk homeward with the wind at my back. I was then so much more comfortable that the aesthetic instinct thawed out in me, and I found myself wondering what use I could make of what I had seen in the way of my trade. Should I have something very pathetic, like the old grandmother, going out day after day to pick up coke for her sick daughter's freezing orphans till she fell sick herself? What should I do with the family in that case? They could not be left at that point, and I promptly imagined a granddaughter, a girl of about 18, very pretty and rather proud, a sort of belle in her humble neighborhood, who should take her grandmother's place. I decided that I should have her Italian, because I knew something of Italians, and I could manage that nationality best. And I should call her Maddalena. Either Maddalena or Marina. Marina would be more Venetian, and I saw that I must make her Venetian. Here I was on safe ground, and at once the love interest appeared to help me out. By virtue of the law of contrast, it appeared to me in the person of a Scandinavian lover, tall, silent, blonde, who I at once felt I could do from my acquaintances with Scandinavian lovers in Norwegian novels. His name was Janssen, a good, distinctive Scandinavian name. I do not know, but it is Swedish, and I thought he might very well be a Swede. I could imagine his manner from that of a Swedish waitress we once had. Jan Janssen, say, drove the coke cart, which Marina's grandmother used to follow out of the coke yard, to pick up the bits of coke as they were jolted from it. And he had often noticed her with deep indifference. At first he noticed Marina, or Nina, as I soon saw I must call her, with the same unconcern. For in her grandmother's hood and jacket and check apron, with her head held shamefacedly downward, she looked exactly like the old woman. I thought I would have Nina make herself sacrifice rebelliously, as a girl like her would apt to do, and follow the coke cart with tears. This would catch Janssen's notice, and he would wonder, perhaps with a little pang, what the old woman was crying about. And then he would see that it was not the old woman. He would see that it was Nina, and he would be in love with her at once. For she would not only be very pretty, but he would know that she was good, if she were willing to help her family in that way. He would respect the girl in his dull, sluggish, northern way. He would do nothing to betray himself. But little by little, he would begin to befriend her. He would carelessly overload his cart before he left the yard, so that the coke would fall from it more lavishly. And not only this, but if he saw a stone or a piece of coal in the street, he would drive over it, so that more coke would be jolted from his load.